is, what it do, what it is, lads and ladettes. It's your boy Dakota Griswold of Gamers, Nerds, and Geeks United. Welcome back to Yesterday Today. This is the show where I bring you some of the biggest news you may have missed from yesterday today. And before we really get into that, I want to give you some housekeeping. Tonight at 12 o'clock, it's finally here. The Last of Us Part 2 is officially arriving, and I will be streaming it at 12 a.m. live right here on YouTube from my PS4. Now, give me a little slack here. I haven't really figured out the camera thing, but I will try to see if I can figure it out. And I'm definitely going to be streaming it regardless. If you have enjoyed me talking about The Last of Us in the last few weeks, if you enjoy my passion for it, you get to see me play it and enjoy it and see my emotional journey, because, you know, just playing the sequel to the game, the first video game that ever made me cry, and the first video game where I really say is probably the greatest story in video game history that absolutely changed my perception on games and my perception on story, because I haven't really been able to finish. I think that's really where it started. I haven't been able to finish a lot of games because if I didn't really care about the story or the characters, I'm not really going to care about the game. But let's get into the appetizers with housekeeping out of the way. 12 o'clock, I will be streaming it. I'll be going live, and I'll wait till about 12:01, and then I will start the game. Now, let us jump into the appetizers. Well, yesterday there was a big Pokemon Presents broadcast, and we got a couple Pokemon games. But first, we got a one just for the phone app. Yep. It's called Pokemon Smile to help encourage children brush their teeth. Listen, if you got the platform, absolutely use it. They basically pull it up. It's an augmented reality game. And just stuff happens. A cake pops up and stuff comes on the kid's head. It's really cute and really awesome. So, listen, Pokemon, you keep doing your thing. They got Pokemon Sleep. They got Pokemon Smile. They're trying to seemingly cover all aspects of your life. Moving on to the next piece of the appetizer. So, I'm a huge Deus Ex fan. Not of the original series, but the new ones with Adam Jensen that's gotten made over the last maybe 5 to 10 years, I want to say. And somebody else who might be an even bigger fan of me and a fan of Dreams, Inside Dreams, their name is Bear Parker. They created Adam Jensen's room from the sequel. And, well, they basically want you to help clean his room. Yeah, clean his room. They created a simulator just to tidy up the room. And honestly, he basically said it's an absolute tip. That's how that's exactly how he described the bedroom, and it's hilarious. And yes, you know, with Adam Jensen being a guy who's private security and stuff like that, he doesn't have enough time to be home cleaning up his room. So there's another game, Inside Dreams, where you can absolutely do that, no problem. And I think this is funny, and I feel like a lot of people are doing so many beautiful, creative things with Dreams. And hey, I encourage y'all to keep it up. Moving on to the next piece of the appetizer. Well, people who've been looking for a Harry Potter game and heard about that Harry Potter RPG rumor some years ago, we might hear something about it soon. Where there's 4 different URLs that have been registered, and there's supposed to be like this big fandom event that's possibly happening. And those URLs read Happy Potter Fandom, Fantastic Beasts Fandom, love those movies, and Porter Key Games Fandom. And this is something that's possibly going to happen, and it's running with DC Comics, and hopefully we get to hear something. And, you know, a lot of, you know, J.K. Rowling, the writer of the Harry Potter series, she's kind of under fire for some comments she recently made, and I'm wondering if that'll affect this right now. But hey, listen, I'm a semi Harry Potter fan. I love the world, I love the fantasy world, so I can't wait to hear more about this. Moving on to the last chunk of the appetizers. Well, Google Stadia is in the news. Kind of negative, but kind of positive. They've lowered the price of their Premier Edition. It was previously $129. It is now $99. And it's as of yesterday, June 16th. Well, two days ago, on June 16th. And listen, hey, if you want to get people to come in and, you know, basically get into your platform, you got to kind of adapt. And they said it would usually cost $138 for both a Wi-Fi enabled Stadia controller and a Chromecast Ultra. So you're saving basically $40 there. And now it actually sounds like a deal if you are interested in the platform. I'm still not quite interested. I'm not knocking it because there's no killer app on it. Not as of yet. Now let's move on to the next piece of the platter, the meat and potatoes. So remember that game Bugsnax that we saw that from the developers that also made Octodaddy? Well, they explained to us why the DualSense controller is such a big deal on the PS5. And they basically said, running around in the environment and feeling the different types of terrain under your feet while sprinting is really cool and weird. Past vibration in games has felt good. It's a nice addition, but it's never been essential, I guess. Now it feels like it makes a big difference in the game, and that's just based off the haptic feedback that's on the controller. Every time I hear more news about the PS5, I absolutely get more and more excited. The fact that you can feel the difference of the ground that you're walking on through the controller, I don't think people, some people are like, it is what it is. But until you really, really feel it, I haven't really felt that per se, but until you really feel that, you'll be like, wow, this is absolutely different. And given the fact that you're playing other games, I can't wait to see what it feels like. I'm still trying to see if they can confirm that feature to see how long certain things would take in the game. But this haptic feedback feature sounds like straight up fire, and I'm excited for this. Not gonna play Bugsnax, but this feature absolutely sounds awesome. And if we're gonna talk about feeling on different terrains, let's talk about Horizon Forbidden West. Yes, the game I forgot to talk about when I was talking about my PS5 reveal event. So basically, they're actually talking about releasing it in 2021, which I am okay with. Take all the time you need. The first one, it was an amazing game. And this also gives me time to go back and finish that game, because Sony is releasing some big hits this year, and then they can use the third party to carry them from here on to the next generation. Tomorrow, we are getting The Last of Us. Next month, we are getting Ghost of Tsushima. And then after that, we have no bigger releases coming out. We're probably going to get some smaller releases sprinkled out throughout the year. But we still have Cyberpunk 2077, Tony Hawk, and Avengers, some of the bigger games that's slated to come out the rest of the year. And it's going to carry us out to the PS5. And hopefully, Horizon Zero Dawn comes out February, March, because it came out around the same time as The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, and they were kind of in competition for Game of the Year. But I'm excited. I really want them to take their time. And they also said it's virtually no load screens. So a lot of the times, and I'm not going to say Horizon had this problem, but a lot of games that you use fast travel, you go to a new area, these loading screens are very atrocious. So could you really imagine playing a game like Horizon Zero Dawn with the DualSense controller, feeling the environment on your hand basically, and under Aloy's feet, and you just click fast travel and you get there pretty much instantaneously, and you feel a difference, like, oh, I'm in a different area, and you feel that haptic feedback. That's pretty awesome. And take all the time you need to fully realize the technology in the controller and the technology that is in the PS5. And I am super, super excited about this. So let's move on to the next story. Now, when Rockstar, being one of the bigger developers, when something happens with them, people listen, and it makes waves. So a guy on Twitter by the name of Nick Plays Games X, he went and looked at Rockstar employees Sarah Over and her LinkedIn, and it says she's working on Red Dead Online in addition to a TBA title. And people are wondering what that could possibly be. Could it be the Red Dead Redemption remake? Hey man, give us a Red Dead Revolver remake. Honestly, I would love to play that game again. Could it be a Bully 2? Could it be some completely new tentative title? Was Manhunt Rockstar? I don't even remember. Or they can give us just a completely new title, because Rockstar, they do their thing. I'm just not a super huge fan of Rockstar games, but I know I give credit where it's due. They definitely make amazing games. Red Dead Redemption wasn't for me, and GTA wasn't for me, but I know those are really great games. Great stories. They definitely know how to make narratives. So whatever Rockstar has cooking in the oven, it's gonna be some straight up fire. They're not gonna burn it. It's gonna be a straight, wonderful dish served up hot and ready for it consumption. Now, for the last bit of news, I have another piece of Pokemon news for you. And in the big N64 era, we got a blue Nintendo 64 with Pikachu on it, and that came with the Pokemon Snap bundle. But we have a new Pokemon Snap game completely confirmed, and it's set for coming soon. But it's a beautiful new Pokemon Snap game for the Nintendo Switch. I'm not the hugest Pokemon fan, I'm not a really big fan. I wasn't that big a fan of Snap. I thought it was cool, but this game actually looks pretty cool. You're gonna be able to go to different islands and basically just put every stuff in your photo decks and see new Pokemon emotions. Here's an official word from the Pokemon developer. They said, the new Pokemon Snap game for the Nintendo Switch system is based on its namesake, which was the first released for the Nintendo 64 console in 1999. The game will take trainers on an adventure to unknown islands overflowing with natural sights such as jungles and beaches, where they can research various Pokemon in their natural habitats. They will take photos to make their very own in-game Pokemon Photodex, all while discovering new, never-before-seen Pokemon expressions and behaviors. This sounds good. The Steve Irwin of Pokemon games, kind of. You're sitting there, you're flicking pictures, and you're just looking at the Pokemon. And honestly, there has been at least maybe 1,000 new Pokemon since the original Pokemon Snap. So this is going to be a pretty long and pretty fun game. So, hey, I actually think I want to check this out because I just, you know, just for a minute, you know, get to take the beauty of it. I'm wondering if they're going to use it, if I'm going to be the guy walking around portably with my Switch, if they use that feature, trying to snap the pictures and using some AR features. Honestly, this actually seems exciting. And listen, Nintendo might not have had Direct, but some Nintendo games are still coming out. And we getting the Isle of Armor, we getting basically new DLC for the latest Pokemon game. And then we're still getting Pokemon Snap. Of course, Mario as well next month. Yeah, Nintendo still seems to be okay this year. Lads and ladders, thank you so much for watching. Please tune in at 12 a.m. tonight. Tomorrow morning, kind of, you know, whatever, however that works, and 9 a.m. Pacific time if you are on the West Coast. Like the video if you liked it. If not, it's all good. Hit the dislike. Let me know down in the comments below if you're happy that there's finally a Pokemon Snap game. Let me know what you think about the haptic feedback in the controllers and what you think about Horizon 2 basically coming out next year. Please hit the subscribe button and hit that notification bell and subscribe up to all so you know when your boy is posting. And before I leave, I always want to say, I absolutely love video games, but I never said I was good at them. So that's definitely going to apply to tonight's stream. Hopefully you don't hate the way I play the games. But lads and ladders, this video is finito.